Hello everybody, it's Dare here, and welcome to Return of the Obra Dinn. This is a new game by Lucas Pope. I'm about to say Alex Pope for some reason, I'm not really sure why. Lucas Pope is of course the creator of Papers, Please, among others. However, Return of the Obra Dinn is very, very much different. We're going to take on the role as an investigative insurance guy, as the Obra Dinn has returned to port mysteriously with no crew. Let's begin. Lost at sea, 1803. The good ship Obra Dinn. Built 1796, London. Captain R. Witterall. Crew 51 men. Last voyage to Orient, Cape Rendezvous, what did the last one say? Attention, Chief Inspector, Insurance and Claims, London Office. That's us! The Obra Dinn has returned. Dispatched to Falmouth immediately and prepare to a full assessment. Falmouth, England, 1807.
Company man woke me up. Said you'd need ferry to the Obra Dinn.
Yes, please.
Not many eager for that job.
Well, you know, it's what I'm hired to do.
Seems a bit late if you ask.
I didn't.
What's in the box?
I don't know. I'll hoist it up in a few minutes.
Hey! Ow!
Carefully.
Okay. Whoa. So, this is a very peculiar style. It's 3D, but at the same time, it's 1-bit. I mean, it looks very interesting. Oh my god. It looks very beautiful, I think. It's so weird. It's like you're inside an old computer. Those vector graphics that they used in Star Wars.
You're required to maneuver straight down this trench and skim the surface to this point.
So this is the Obra Dinn. Hi. What are we going to do here? Yes? Oh, there's someone dead here. Oh no! Hi guy, how did you die? So it's our job to determine the fate of the Obra Dinn. What happened while they were at sea? What's that? Something is blinking in the distance. I don't know.
Oi! It's too heavy!
Oh come on! Put some muscles into it, you scallywag! Amazing insults, I know. We don't actually want to insult him though, I think. Hi. Can you like... Oh, that's weird. He automatically grips the stuff. Okay, I'm going down. Apparently I'm going down. Right. That's clearly everything we ever wanted.
Take it yourself or open it here.
Okay. Well. A book. Yes. It's a book. All right. Oh, okay. Return of the Obra Dinn, catalog of adventure and tragedy. Skim through the entire book first. Oh. Preface. I trust that you know how to find yourself aboard the Obra Dinn. I expected this day to come, and my every intention was to tell the ship's strange tale within the pages of this book. Regrettably, failing health has allowed me to produce only the basic outline that follows. Your presence on the Obra Dinn is critical. I leave the discovery of its fate and it's the completion of this book in your hand. The next few pages will seem bewildering at first. All will make sense in time. Use the pocket watch to determine the identity and the fate of everyone aboard. Complete each chapter accurately and return the book to by guaranteed post to the French Office of Affairs in Morocco. Okay. The bargain chapter will remain unknown to you. I possess the details within, but have elected to keep them private for now. Okay, contents. The journey. The ship. The crew. Life at sea. Sketch. Glossary. And back cover. Oh my god, there's a lot of chapters here. So the journey. Oh, we can see here where they went. So they sailed from the bottom of Africa all the way to England. The deck plans. I don't really know what to make of this. They're very detailed. Great. Complete crew and passenger list. Captain, first mate, blah 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 blah. Oh, they had a lot of passengers. Ship steward, first mate, topman, seaman. Seaman.
It's sea, man, and swallow. Okay, seaman, you guys head off. Fine. Swallow, come.
This is a sketch of life aboard, I guess. Justice at sea. Okay. Wow. Are they keel hauling someone? Man, I hope not. Okay, loose cargo. On the cargo deck. Bitter cold. Okay, so we have to find out something about the loose cargo. Right. Do I have to skip through all the pages first? Murder? Bargain. This chapter will remain unknown until you leave the ship and return the book to me. Escape. Do I have to escape? Why do we have a skull here? That seemed horrible. Open, close book, and table cut. Right. Okay, and then we have a pocket watch with the same skull! Memento mortem. Remember death. Okay. Sure. I guess we go up and remember death then. Oh, we can zoom it. Zoom a little bit. Oh, hi. Ooh, what did I do? I pressed the mouse button at the skeleton.
Captain, open the door. Kick it in.
Was there a mutiny going on?
Take it down and take more than those shells.
You bastard, mate. Take exactly what I give you.
Oh, whoa. Oh, hi. Wait, did the captain shoot this guy? Oh, this is so cool. Sort of looked like the Matrix. You can walk around. Oh my god. Who this? Oh, we have seen him in the sketch or what? No? Okay. Is there a time limit? Hi, you. Where do we see you? Is that the captain? I don't know. Oh, this must be the captain. Yeah, this must be the captain. He had barricaded himself. We can't actually get inside. Okay, there seems to be a time limit. Okay, the guy in the suit there was one we saw on a sketch, I guess, at Life at Sea. Okay. Oh, the end. Wait, are we starting at the end? Outside the captain's quarters. Oh, location of the corpse. Three others were present. The captain. Wait. Who's this? How did they die? So it was the captain who... captain, open the door. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Exactly what I give to you. Three others were present. Unknown. And then this guy. One memory. Memories... where this person appeared can navigate from here. Oh. First memory, bookmark memories. Okay. Bookmark all memories where they appear for quicker navigation. One memory. I'm not sure what we need to find here. Oh, did I just walk out of the memory? Ah, okay. Oh, it's open now. Oh, that's freaking creepy. Musho, I can hear you. Okay. This is so weird and creepy. Okay, so this gotta be the captain, I guess. Let's see. What does he have to show us?
Where are they?
Must be in here someplace.
They're at the bottom of the sea.
That's a lie.
So there's a brawl. Oh no. Oh, dude. Oh, Captain. Oh, Captain, Captain, Captain. Well, we better notice them. So here, this is Captain. This is... Oh, it's that guy again. So he didn't actually... Or maybe this... No, this was after, so he didn't die when the captain shot the other guy. Well, I guess there was only one corpse outside as well. Then there's someone here. Who are you? You're that guy on the life at sea. Interesting. Interesting. Is that all of them? The soundtrack is amazing for this game. Okay, this was inside the captain's quarters. We're still on the end. It's weird, we're starting at the end. Two others were present. He's still unknown. And then we had this guy up here. He's in two memories. Show memories on deck map. So he's here. End part one, part two. I'm a little bit confused right now. There are a lot of things going on at the same time. I'm not really sure where to go with all this information. How do we figure out who they are? So, this is a captain. This must be the first mate. This unknown soul met an unknown fate. This person's face appeared blurred throughout the book. This blurring indicates that you don't yet have sufficient information to determine their identity. Okay. Their fate may be known and can be entered now. Trying to name them while their face is blurred would be unproductive. Okay, carry on and pay attention. Faces will become unblurred when the information necessary to identify them has been revealed in some way. Okay, well, we know he died. Struck, suicide. Ooh, suicide. He got shot. By a gun. Was shot with a gun by an unknown attacker. Nope, it was not an unknown attacker. It was the captain. Oh, maybe we need to be sure that this is the captain. Yes. This person's face is no longer blurred, which means that it can now be identified. Use the book and the pocket watch to gather enough information to deduce their identity. Revisit memories on the ship using the pocket watch to study relationship appearances and activities. Use the book maps, crew manifest, and artist sketches along with the individual conversation logs to find clues about. There were 60 people on the ship when I left England. Determining everyone's identity and fate will not be easy. Decisive information is rare. You'll have to make assumptions using partial information. Some identities may only be revealed through a process of elimination. Good luck. Oh, dang it. We're pretty sure this is the captain. This is the captain. Captain Robert Vitterall. Captain Robert shotgun unknown. No. We know it was Captain Vitterall. I think. I hope so. Then we have this guy. He died. He got knifed by an unknown attacker, by also the Captain Vitterall, right? Can we change this, by the way? Oh, we can. Okay, that's nice. This is really cool, though. This the investigative detective work that we have to do. It's so interesting. And then something else happened. It's so cool, Liz, that we are walking around in memories. So I wonder what's about to happen here. Is he the one who kills the captain? Or does... No, there were only one corpse here. How do we stop using the pocket watch? Are we not done here? Is there more things we can see? Wait a minute. Did he just get hit by a stick? Why would you bring a stick to a knife fight? That seems weird. Look sensitivity, perfect. Well, that's a perfect look sensitivity. Monitor, Macintosh. Oh my god. You can watch on different screens. Oh, that's so cool. Oh my god. That's so weird. Let's just use the Macintosh the way it was intended, apparently. Now, can I... Or do I have to go outside this door here? Oh, okay. So it acts as a portal, I guess. Oh, the knife is here. Oh my god! That arm! It just comes up and then it's like, no! I need to grab the handle! the sugar pack. We saw someone jump down here. Did he commit suicide? No, I don't think so. Oh wait, there's another one here. Sounds like someone drowning in their own blood. Oh my! Yep, someone was drowning in their own blood. And it was this guy. And then the captain defended himself against this guy with a stick. Oh wait, the stick was had a pointy end. Wow, okay, that makes much more sense that he wanted to attack him then. Hi, yes, you are that guy. No one is saying anything though. I'm guessing that the captain died because he got stabbed by this guy and that guy. It's at the captain's quarters. Location at the court. Who is this? How did they die? Well, they died. This unknown soul, they died. They were clubbed to death, looked like. Clubbed by the captain. Oh, this door is open now. Oh my god, it's open now. There's someone here. It's a lady of sorts, I guess. Who are they? Is she dead? I think she's still alive. I'm still a little bit weirded out as we go here again, but how we add stuff to whoa, what the fudge? This door, is that bugging? Or because I guess it was actually, no, she died as well. Ah, maybe she died of illness. I guess it was opened up through the memory. And in here, well, so many dead people.
Abigail. Your brother, my friend. I shot him dead. I'll be with you soon, my love. Please forgive me for everything.
Wait a minute. So the one who died out there, here. Oh my god, that's not the captain. No, the captain committed suicide. And this is Abigail. The captain! The captain committed suicide! No one else was present. Abigail. Captain Robert Witherard met an unknown fate. Okay. Yeah, he didn't meet an unknown fate. Yeah, okay. He committed suicide. By gun. Shot himself. Bam! Nailed it! This may or may not be correct. Fates are validated in sets of three. Currently, correctly identify at least three people and their fates to have the information typeset into the book. But that was correct, wasn't it? Abigail. Your brother, my friend. I shot him dead. I'll be with you soon, my love. Forgive me for everything. So now we know that... Well, this is Abigail for once. Why can I not correctly identify her? She was there! This is Abigail! What? This was the brother of Abigail. So this guy was unknown soul. Okay, Abigail Huskett Witherall. Abigail Huskett. There are no other Abigail on board. Okay, William Huskett. It was the first mate. I called it. Years and years ago, Husket. First mate was shot to gun by this guy. No, he wasn't shot by this guy. That was himself. I don't know what I'm talking about. Okay, so I guess we go in back in here and go back to the book. It's actually not what I wanted, but sure. What's that? Is that four fates? This unknown, so we still don't know who they were. No one else was present. Well, that's just plain lying. She was goddamn present. This was Abigail. I guess she died of illness of sorts. Oh no! Okay, so she died from a head injury by a Kraken? What the fudge? This whole case just blew wide open! Release the Kraken! Oh no, Abigail. Abigail, Abigail, Abigail! Okay, open book. Open book while examining a face to flip directly to the sketch. Right. This was Abigail. Abigail Husket Whitwell. She was just a passenger. Well, she was also the wife of the captain, who was not here. Okay. And then we had this guy. Who dead? We don't know who that is. This was not the end, I guess. This was the... Okay, we haven't actually figured out where that is yet. Oh, we have more people here! Someone... That guy, okay. And... That guy with a great big high hat. And she was pretty much smashed... by... something... Oh, there are more people! No, there's so many more people that we didn't get to see! The Doom! I love the music. The Doom! Here comes the Doom! Inside the captain's quarters. Corpse was moved post-mortem. Abigail Husket Whitwell met an unknown fate. Yeah, that was not an unknown fate. She was crushed. Beast? Maybe? Crushed by a terrible beast? Well done. Three fates were correct. Yes. So nice. I'm so good at this game. William Husket, first mate. Ah, so he gets. So he gets put into the book when they're correct. Oh my god! And then we have to determine the fate of every passenger. Holy smokes! Wait, what's happening now? What? What? We could do something here. Oh, wait, okay. What is going on? I don't know what's going on. Something died here? So this is like a corpse of a memory, I guess. Well, unfortunately, that is all the time that we have for this episode of the Obra Dinn, a return of the Obra Dinn. This is super interesting. I love the detective work that is required. I love the style, the music, the soundtrack is amazing. The voice acting is really good. I think I want to continue this in a live stream of sorts, and let's see if we can actually play through and see what ending that we get. I don't know how long the game is. It's probably going to be multiple live streams, but we'll see. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please remember to like it on YouTube and maybe even subscribe to me if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next one. Over and out.